just some questions about how this entire pandemic, the shutdown, the quarantine, what impact is that going to have on Manny's career? Manny's 41 years old. He'll be 42 in December. At this point, he's coming up on being inactive for a year. I got to ask you, Peter, I want to know how you think this is going to affect Manny's career moving forward.
I mean, look, pandemic, no pandemic, Manny's been fighting once a year anyway recently.
Yeah.
So, I mean, he fought Broner. We'll start with the Broner fight, January of 2019. He did follow that up with Thurman in July of 2020, right?
Yes.
And so it's very conceivable that we're looking at, under the best of circumstances, I think Manny would have been fighting maybe October, November at this point. But I mean, look, Manny's on borrowed time. You know, Manny, he's had such an unbelievable career. I mean, the only fighter in the history of boxing to have world titles in 8 different weight classes, that'll never be replicated. No one's ever going to do that again. He's a special fighter. Obviously, now as he's toward the twilight of his career, I think that for him, he doesn't mind the inactivity as much as he would have, you know, in previous years. You know, partly because obviously the earning potential, but also because fighters just need to stay active. I think at his age, it's a benefit for him to maybe not put that, you know, that work on his body. He's very methodical when he goes into camp. I mean, he's been doing this for so many years, so many fights at the world championship level. And look, he's still beating top guys. You know, having beaten, if we really want to go back, starting with after he lost to Floyd, how he beat, name's escaping me.
Lucas Matisse.
No, before that.
Tim Bradley.
No, after Bradley.
Oh, Jesse Vargas.
Right, okay. So we'll go to Vargas, right? He beats Vargas. He loses a highly controversial fight to Jeff Horn.
Right.
He then goes and beats Lucas Matisse.
Beats
Adrian Broner. Beats Keith Thurman. I mean, you know, Manny's been on a win streak since, what, 2016, if you take away the Horn fight. I know you got to count the Horn fight to what I'm saying. Mm-hmm. Okay, so 2018. So what I'm saying, I know you have to count the Horn fight. Mm-hmm. But it was a very close fight, right?
Yeah.
I was there. It was very difficult to judge because it was a sloppy fight. The point I'm making is that even at his age, Manny's still performing at the top level. So I'm not sure that this added time off is going to play that much of a difference in his preparation. If anything, he's going to be well-rested. He knows what he's doing when he goes into camp. And the one thing that you just can't make up for is experience. The other thing is, who's Manny going to fight? You know, that question still remains to be answered. So I can tell you, you know, I had heard by good authority that it wasn't going to be Mikey Garcia, even though a lot of people still think that was something that was on the table. Mm-hmm. And it just begs the question, you know, who is there for Manny to fight? And at what point does Manny start to say, okay, this is going to be my last fight? Is it going to be when he loses, or is it going to be where he's going to say, okay, this is my last fight, win, lose, or draw? But to answer your question, I don't think it's going to affect them at all, actually. I think that he's still doing his duties as a senator in the Philippines, and I still think that just Manny, by his nature, is staying in shape. I mean, in General Santos City, he has a basketball court, you know, in his house, so he loves playing basketball. It's in his nature just to stay fit. So I think that, you know, from what I've seen historically, he takes like a 6 to 7 week training camp at most.
Right.
And so, when everything gets back to normal, he'll get back to work. And I think that it's just not going to have any effect on him. I think if there's one person it's just not going to affect right now, it's going to be Manny.
Yeah, you know, I can understand why you would say that. But I feel almost like it's almost impossible for something like this not to have an impact. And I think right now what we're talking about more or less is a physical impact. But I'm almost thinking more of a mental or an emotional impact. And I'm saying he's somewhere destitute. And obviously, like you said, he's still carrying out his duties and his responsibilities as a politician. So he's not sitting home as idle as maybe someone else is. I mean, we talked to Javonte and he was absolutely in chill mode when we talked to him a few weeks ago. So I know I know that's not Manny. But I am looking at the fact that he hasn't fought since July of 2019. At the absolute earliest, I could see Manny fighting. It would have to be something like August or September. And to me, that's at the absolute earliest, based off of where we are. And who knows? Maybe he fights in another country where the social distancing situation isn't as stringent as it is in the United States right now. Who knows? I don't know how that works. But for me, I'm looking at his age. And I'm looking at how he'll have to get up emotionally and get up from a mental standpoint. And it's a lot of transition, a lot of jumping back and forth from what he's doing right now in terms of just being a politician and getting back into fight mode. So I wonder how that will work. Now, on the flip side of that, I do see how this could actually, on another hand, could potentially extend him out a little bit more.
Right.
Manny had gotten into a point where he was fighting top-notch competition back to back to back. We just talked about all of the fighters that he'd faced since he lost to Mayweather, almost really not missing a beat, fighting guys who everybody, for the most part, recognizes by name. Because of this shutdown, because nobody has had boxing, nobody has had combat sports, because everybody's so starving for boxing, I don't think that there is the requirement necessarily for Manny to fight another top name at this point. I think a Manny fight against just about anybody that PBC can line up would be well received whenever boxing gets back, just because it's boxing and just because it's Manny. And because of that, now Manny gets a pay-per-view size payday, and that's significant, I think. And I think that's in a way how this whole situation can ultimately benefit Manny and stretch him out. You give him this fight, a fight that he's more than likely going to handle as long as there's not any significant drop-off of who he is. He gets to make a good piece of change for a relatively low risk and doesn't have to worry about any of the backlash for fighting his equivalent to Rocky Fielding. So I think that in that way you might be looking at a way where it helps to extend him.
I don't think they're going to do that. I don't think that's in Manny's plans. The one thing I can tell you is that this sort of levels the playing field. What I mean by that, you have a lot of guys that are in quarantine right now. A lot of guys that are usually in the gym, staying in shape, even if they're not preparing for a particular fighter in camp, they're still going through the motions. They're still doing their road work. They're still doing things in the gym the way that they normally do them. They're right now inside, right? So they're the ones who are used to having, more activity. There could be more of a ring rust for a Pacquiao potential opponent, right, at a high-level opponent, that this could actually benefit Manny because Manny's used to this inactivity. And I made a mistake earlier in our show. I said that he fought Thurman in July, it was July 20, but it was July 20, 2019. Look, I think that if anything, it's going to potentially be an advantage for Manny when he does come back. And I think that time off for him, it's really nothing crazy. So. And I don't think they're going to give him a soft touch, as we like to say. I think that because of how often he's fighting, because of the potential opponents that are out there, because they have a need to do a pay-per-view around Manny, I think that that's something that would play into the fact that look, the clock is ticking, right? I mean, there's only so much longer that Manny can actually fight. The other thing is, the other things surrounding, I mean, there's a lot of rumors. Is Manny's tax situation really taken care of? Is he going to fight in the United States? Is he going to fight overseas? Is he still working with PBC? Is he not working with PBC? There have been so many rumors swirling around. Did he sign with Paradigm Sports? And is that going to open the door for him fighting a Conor McGregor? Like, all these answers that we're still waiting for regarding Manny are just kind of going to extend. So, you know, I know that doesn't really play into the inactivity, or does it hurt him or not, but I just think that at this point, Manny has one, maybe two fights left in him, and that's that.